12th, I will tell you about the phasor diagram. This is a very important part of the AC circuit. The diagram which shows the phase difference between alternating current and voltage is called phasor diagram. You know that the name suggests phasor. Phasor means the phase. In case of DC, the voltage and current are in the same phase, so we have no phasor diagram. But in case of AC, since this is having the frequency, and whenever this is passed in the circuit, then there is a phase difference between the current and the voltage. So this phase difference depends upon the elements, which kind of elements have been used. So now I will tell the phasor diagram. This is like this one. This is now zero. This is x, this is y, this is x dash, and this is now y dash. So this, suppose we are having the, it is for current I, and suppose we are having the voltage, this is now this one, this is now voltage V. So the phase difference between them is so much. This is not so much. This is now phase difference is now phase difference between these two. This is not phase difference. This is now phi. So this phase difference is taken with respect to the voltage and the current. You can have this current like this one or current away ahead to this voltage. So these are taken in this way, in the sense of anti-clockwise. This is now in this way. No. So these rotates in this direction. So this is not direction of rotation, like this. So this I and B both. So this phase difference phi will depend upon the element used in the circuit. So this phi may be zero, positive or negative. Both the values are there. And this is always taken with respect to the voltage. So we have the phase difference between the voltage and the current. Phase difference. Phase difference between voltage and current. This is equal to phi. So now what we have? if phi is equal to 0 degree. It means that current and voltage are in the same phase, i.e. the current the voltage and current are in same phase. Same phase. Then AC circuit will have only resistor. So how to switch this one? That is, suppose we are having and another one is like this. This one is what, the bigger size. This is now 0. This is now x. This is now your y. This is x dash. This is now y dash. And rotation is like this one. So this will be. This is now your v, and this is I. So they are in the same phase. This phase difference, the between V and I, there is no phase difference at all. So phi is equal to 0. This is happens when the resistor is there. And now I take the second case. If phi is equal to positive. Phi is positive means that there is only the inductor. There will be inductor only in AC circuit. It means that the voltage leads the current. Leads the current. And which elements can be there? Elements either inductor or resistor and inductor both. तो इसमें दो एलिमेंट हो सकते हैं, या तो इंडक्टर होगा या फिर रजिस्टर और इंडक्टर, दोनों ही होंगे. तो जब phi का मान पॉजिटिव होता है तो इसकी वोल्टेज होती है वो करंट को लीड करती है, तो वोल्टेज इसमें आगे होता है. तो दैट इज वी कैन शो इट बाय डायग्राम लाइक दिस. Now this is like this. This is now your 0. This is now x, y, x dash and y dash. And this is now your current. this is for current I, and this is for V. Distance of is phi. Distance of phi. So voltage is ahead to the current, or voltage leads the current. So current always remains behind this voltage V. Now the third case. If phi is equal to negative, then the voltage lags behind the current, or the current leads the voltage. We can say that current leads the voltage. Here this voltage leads the current, but here this current leads the voltage, or voltage lags behind the current. The elements कौन कौन से हो सकते हैं इसमें? एलिमेंट्स इसमें हो सकते हैं आइदर कैपेसिटर और रेजिस्टर एंड कैपेसिटर. सो हम इसको कैसे शो करेंगे ना, ये हम कैसे शो कर सकते हैं इसको? वेरी सिंपल वन. दिस इज नाउ एक्स, दिस इज नाउ वाई, दिस इज नाउ एक्स डैश, दिस इज नाउ वाई डैश. रोटेशन इज लाइक दिस. सो वी आर हैविंग दिस द वोल्टेज, दिस इज नाउ वोल्टेज वी, एंड दिस विल बी द करंट. In this, this is now I. So you can see that current is ahead to this voltage. This is ahead to this voltage. So in this way, current leads the voltage. So by knowing the phase difference between the current and the voltage, you can find two things, that which one of them is leading to the other. Either this voltage is leading to the current, or current is leading to the voltage. And second, you can find that which elements are there. Either to this, suppose this now positive, then there may be the inductor, resistor, and the inductor. And here this is negative, then there may be either capacitor or the resistor and capacitor. If suppose all three elements are there, even this phi will be positive. So this inductor, resistor, and inductor, or here this we can have resistor inductor and capacitor. So there will be all the three elements in this positive one, but in negative there may be only the two elements, either this the capacitor or the resistor and the capacitor. So R and C. Here R and C, and here either this L, R, or R and L, or R, L, C, all the three components may be there. So this is the phasor diagram that gives you the knowledge about the phase difference between the voltage and the current, and the elements which are present in the circuit. So this is also asked in the competitive exams, that if suppose phase difference is plus 45 degree in, or minus 45 degree, or minus plus 30 degree, plus 40 degree, or plus phi or minus phi, then which elements may present in the AC circuit? So in that you can find it easily by having a knowledge of the this phase difference. So this is a very important part of this AC circuit, because in the later lectures I will tell you that how do these phi will change according to the elements used in the AC circuit. So these are very important. So this circuit only have the resistance, this have the resistance and the inductor, or all the 3 ohm, and this has only 2 ohm, the capacitor and the resistor and the capacitor. So thank you very much, and you all like, share and subscribe this video.